infrastructure and work practices. Now, what is the opportunity that Africa offers today you are here, maybe you can, you want to listen to the voice of Africa to see if there is a possibility. Yes. In the CDM side, the special proposal is to invest in equity and debt and intermediation in Africa. We have what we call the Africa Carbon Fund. The Africa Carbon Fund will purchase CR to enhance and back all the projects that we will finance through ABREF. And all this structure is back what we call the African Biofuel Renewable Energy Company. You see it at the bottom there. Yeah. And this company, ABREC, called ABREC, will back all this fund to identify projects, enhance all the capacity inside Africa, and solve the political and some risk problem. You have this structure coming. We have what we call the Africa Bank, equity, and we purchase here. But the main thing here is the African Clean Energy Technical Assistance Facility. We want to build a new competence to manage projects and to come up with the high and good quality project with a good return for our investors. What we will focus to make here, we will make feasibility studies. We will make audit and energy for all our countries in private and public sector. We will make the PDD. I think he explained you what is the PDD, the project preparation cost, and the capacity building. And you see the African Biofuel Renewable Energy Company, ABREC, will identify projects, support management, liaison, and support of the fund manager. Today, ABREC has already identified around 100 projects, feasible and bankable projects in different areas that you will see here.
It is like, but it's also very critical. Let me expand a little bit on women entrepreneurship. And I'm not talking about scientists, engineers, and things like that. Look, let's look at a rural perspective, where women raise children, the husbands go to work in a construction job or something. A woman can be assisted by a government or a local agency to become an entrepreneur and help sustain the family. For example, if you gave a woman in Peru or Africa somewhere one panel of solar, they can connect that to a refrigerator. Everybody in that community can have iced water or iced Coke or 7-Up to drink and calm them down, kids can do. They can also have ice cream. The woman can also start a business charging cell phones for everybody in the community. I mean, this may be uncommon to you, but let's look at it. So let's look at the importance of electricity from that economic perspective.